On refactoring your language knowledge portfolio. I want to talk a little bit about questioning what we do and how we could go off and adapt a certain different paradigm of programming. And we've been programming in a certain way for a long time, and there's been a few different paradigms. So it's a good time to kind of re-question and rethink about what we do. So that's what I want to do here. Let's talk a little bit about, you know, where we are and what we do. We work in a very exciting field. And if I kind of reflect back in my own life and what I've done over the years, I started programming when I was in school. And of course, I wanted to be an engineer. And I really got drawn into computer science and computer science and engineering. I went on to do I got a BS in computer engineering. I went on to do a electrical engineering master's. But then I kind of came back into get a PhD in computer science. So a lot of my work in the initial phase was definitely drawn towards science and engineering. But a few decades later, I am still a programmer. And the reason I'm a programmer is really a little different now. So if I want to kind of reflect back on my time, the science in programming is what drew me in, but it's actually the art in programming that actually kept me in. And the more I program, the more I work with software systems, I realize that it's a form of expression as much as, yes, it is engineering, it is science, and that's kind of what really excites me, the art format of it more than the engineering format of it, even though that part is still important. And as we work through this, I want to kind of reflect back on this quote. It says, I want to stay as close to the edge as I can without going over. Out on the edge, you see all kinds of things you cannot see from the center. And I can relate to this very well on two fronts. One of the things I do when I go home, mostly, is I go mountain hiking. I live near Boulder, Colorado. And I have little boys. My little boy started hiking when he was 4 years old. And he can hike for about nearly 11 hours. He's the most avid hiker that I know personally. And he can do a lot of hiking. And one of the beautiful things about going up the mountain after struggling up there is the view that you enjoy when you're on the edge. And the other edge I'm talking about, of course, is programming. And I want to push the edges and do stuff, and I want to always try something different than what I had done before or I'm used to.